Hey, good evening. How y'all doing? We're going to go ahead and get this council meeting started. Ms. Harris, we're going to ask you to give us a beautiful prayer for the day.
Shall not stray. Lord, let me walk each day with thee. Lead me, oh Lord, all day. Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, oh God. Just want to thank you, Lord, for another day. You've been so good. You've been so kind. We lift you up high, oh God, in this city, God, in this council meeting, oh God. Cover us right now, oh God. Lift us right now, oh God. Encourage each and every one, oh God. Continue, Lord, keep our mayor. Rock him in the cradle of your love, oh God. Continue with his vision, oh God. Lord, we want to thank you right now because you've been so good, you've been so kind. And we thank you for another Mother's Day coming, oh God. Bless every mother that it is, oh God. Glory to your name, Jesus. We bless you right now, God. Continue to lift the city up, oh God. As we take it forward, oh God. Lord, keep us in your care, God. Keep us in your care. Rock us in your cradles of your love. Cover us with your blood. Lift us with your love. Let that love connect with each other, God. Lord, we thank you right now. We thank you right now, God. We thank you for freedom, oh God. Glory to your name, Jesus. Thank you for rebuking COVID-19, oh God, in this city, God, and all the cities around. Thank you for our first responders, God. Continue to bless the fire department and police department. Continue to bless our city workers and sanitation workers, God. Continue to keep the cap on this city, oh God. Glory to your name, Jesus. Wrap us, God. Encourage us, God. Lord, let your spirit dwell in this city. Cover this place with your blood. Fill it with your love, oh God. Wrap it in your mercy, oh God. Do what you do, oh God. Bless this city the more, God. Keep us connected, God, with one another. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and praise.
Amen. 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 Please remain standing for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. City Clerk, will you call the roll, please?
Mayor McClinton.
Present.
City Attorney Stevenson.
Here.
City Treasurer Suter.
Here.
Councilmember Bruce.
Here.
Councilmember Tatt.
Here.
Councilmember Croom.
Here.
Councilmember Harris.
Here.
Councilmember Hope.
Here.
Councilmember Hutchinson.
Here.
Councilmember Muhammad. Councilmember Muhammad. Councilmember Monday.
Here.
Councilmember Murray.
Here.
Councilmember Willis.
Here.
With the quorum being present, 9 out of 10, we'll get started with our meeting. I'm going to call an executive session after we do all of our resolutions and ordinances. I get any corrections to the minutes?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? The minutes are approved. We had no old business. I'm going to ask that we add what would be a 05 and the Chestnut Levy property liens, and someone also to make within that motion read by title only from 01, 02, 03, 04, and 05 if added, and the levy lien.
City Attorney, would you read those by title only?
I would like to, yes. Thank you.
Mayor, make a motion that we add 05 to the agenda, yeah, and the permission request.
Okay. Okay. So Mel, Tracy made the motion, you second.
Okay. Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? Did we do everything?
No, you left out the title.
Okay.
Now we do
it. Yes.
Okay.
I made the motion for the city attorney to read the R1, 01, 02, 03, 04, and 05, and the other by title only.
I get a second.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It's on you, City Attorney.
All right. Ready. R1 is a resolution to distribute Southland Casino Racing Charity Day proceeds by elected officials, Mayor, City Council of the City of West Memphis as provided by law and for other purposes.
I get a motion and second to approve.
So moved.
Second.
In discussion. Hearing none. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. Will you get a resolution number?
It's going to be resolution 2253.
That number is 2253. All right. City Attorney, 01.
01 is an ordinance approving and authorizing the mayor and city clerk to execute an amendment to the power supply agreement with NextEra Energy Marketing, LLC, for additional long-term capacity, declaring an emergency, and for other purposes.
Mayor, yes, sir. Somebody asked that we suspend the rules and place this on the second reading.
I got a second. You second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. City Attorney, 02? I mean, 01, I'm sorry. Second reading.
An ordinance approving and authorizing the mayor and city clerk to execute an amendment to the power supply agreement with NextEra Energy Marketing, LLC, for additional long-term capacity, declaring an emergency, and for other purposes.
Mayor, if I may ask that we further suspend the rules and place it on its third reading.
So,
all in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed?
An ordinance approving and authorizing the mayor and city clerk to execute an amendment to the power supply agreement with NextEra Energy Marketing, LLC, and for additional long-term capacity, declaring an emergency, and for other purposes.
I get a motion and second to approve.
I'm going to move.
Second.
Todd, do you just want to give it a little brief update?
Again, as y'all know, as we move forward into a new world, you know, the mayor talked to us prior when we were having management meetings. We're thinking out of the box. We have the opportunity with a solar facility being built locally within Crittenden County to start changing from fossil fuels to renewable energy. And this portion of the facility is being bought by somebody else. They're buying the energy and the renewable energy credits. So the capacity was available. Because of our ties with NextEra, it was made available to us. We will be able to secure capacity for the city of West Memphis out to 2039. This does not take care of 100%, but it secures about two-thirds of our current capacity needs. So it helps us in securing any financial risk in the future and then stabilizes our costs going forward. What else does this do for us? Year 2024, 3 years from now, we can say that 85% of our capacity resource needs are coming from locally owned solar facilities, locally built solar facilities in our backyard. I don't think anybody else in Arkansas will be able to say that. And that's, again, keeping our rates also where they're at for our customers. Fixed rate. It's a fixed rate contract on the capacity out to 2039.
And we are the second lowest utility rate in this state.
Now, I'll be coming back to y'all. We still have to take care of the energy needs, yeah. Okay? But this is the capacity portion, and this is the part that scares me, because remember, 2028, as y'all know, White Bluff is closing. We own a portion of those plants, have done a lot of good things for us over the years and kept our rates low. We got to start taking care of those resources. 2030, Independence is closing, okay? And that's 3,200 megawatts of capacity coming off of the market that we've got to start addressing, okay?
Todd, when you say start addressing, meaning, I mean, have you started looking at things already?
This is a part of what to start addressing. This is me addressing it.
Okay.
Because this contract starts in 2024, mm-hmm, and goes out to 2039. So, you know, there'd be some other things we're looking at. You know, we might be coming back and looking at potentially building some gas generation or batteries, or, I mean, just any type of technologies that are as they come forward and the price gets to where we can, again, reliable energy, maintaining good, lower cost energy for our customers. be competitive in the world as we know it, and it, as it's changing.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Todd.
Thank you.
All right, if there is any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. Also, can I get a motion and second to approve that emergency clause?
So moved.
Take it.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It's passed with the emergency clause. Mr. Clerk, will you get 01 number, please?
2576.
That number is 2576. Mr. City Attorney, 02.
02 is an ordinance granting a special use permit for all-in-one auto sales, permitting an automotive sales used dealership in a C2 open display commercial district.
Talking with Mr. Councilman Murray, you want to read it out?
Yeah, I would ask that we suspend the rules and put it on second reading.
I get a second?
A second.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? City Attorney?
An ordinance granting a special use permit for all-in-one auto sales, permitting an automotive sales used dealership in a C2 open display commercial district.
Mayor, I would like to ask to suspend the rules and put it on third.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? City Attorney?
An ordinance granting a special use permit for all-in-one auto sales, permitting an automotive sales used dealership in a C2 open display commercial district.
Is there any discussion?
I have some discussion.
Okay.
Okay, I was looking at the recommendations from the Planning Commission. It says no outside storage of wrecked vehicles on the lot. And I'm wanting to address this because we have a lot of dysfunction throughout the city. So basically, what happens if this is violated?
Well, if it's violated, the code enforcement officer is supposed to go out there. Yeah. Yeah, he would go out there and address the violation and write it up.
Okay, I understand that, but we still have a lot of that going on now. Mm-hmm. So if this is what we're going to do, we need to make sure that these different companies are being ticketed, because when we talk about cleaning up the city, and people in Ward 5 are talking about the housing in that area, which is in Ward 5. I know this is a different ward, but we have a lot of this going on in Ward 2. Mm-hmm. So all I ask is that we make sure that when these people violate the ordinances, we act on it. That's all I'm asking.
Okay. That's fair. Matter of fact, the owners are here. Mr. Amble, oh, I'm sorry. Will you stand for a minute? I do agree with Councilman Bruce's, I'm sorry, Dr. Bruce's sentiments. And I think the council will approve this, but we're working hard to make sure we have a clean city, and we just asking you that you all just truly follow the guidelines and do everything that the ordinance say and provide for you to do, and you have a successful business. So I'm just asking you all just to make sure that you follow those guidelines for us, please. All right.
That's all we ask.
Mr. Clark.
Can I ask him to come up personally and give us that word? Because I'm like Councilman Bruce that.
Mr. Clark, how long have you been up on 7th Street?
Wow.
7th Street?
It's been a while.
Like
8 years.
About 8 years?
Does a
and,
good job.
Yeah.
What's the address there?
1075.
Yes. I've been to your business several occasions. I've never seen a wrecked car on that lot. I've never seen a wreck. I haven't. It might have been some there, but it's always neat and clean.
Yeah.
It's always neat. And I wanted to say that about your business, because I frequent your business, and I
want to commend
you on it.
And also, I want to buy this property that he's we are discussing right now, and he's made vast improvements even up to this point on it.
And I agree with that, because yeah, I've been there as well, but I just want to make sure that we continue trying to make sure that our city is cleaned up. Like I said, I haven't seen any wrecked vehicles at your place either, and I commend you for that. But there are some others that we're going to have to look at.
Can
This location, this 509 North 7th, was that a previous car lot?
It was.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Well,
thank you all.
Thank you.
If there's no other discussion, all in favor by aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. Congratulations. Mr. Clerk, will you get O2R number, please?
2577.
2577?
Mm-hmm.
Did we miss something?
I remember I wrote down the first and second reading, but I did not write down the term.
See, the attorney did the first reading, then Councilman Murray did the second and the third.
All right. So who made the motion to approve? I don't think there was a motion to actually approve it after the third reading.
I got a motion and second to approve.
Motion.
Second.
Councilman Wheelis and Councilman Murray did the second. All in favor by aye?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, we got the numbers, 2577?
77.
Okay. City Attorney, O3?
All right. O3 is an ordinance granting a special use permit for Diebel Towing, permitting an auto wrecker service in an I-1 general industrial district.
I didn't hear nothing on this, so they just on for its first reading and be back in 2 weeks for a second reading. O4?
Can I have the address in it?
I think it says 600 to 610 East Jefferson on the ordinance.
I think that's Ward 2 again.
Yeah, I have the same concerns there.
Okay.
You have the same concern.
Okay, well, you go by and look at it, let me know what you're feeling, and we'll...
I'm gonna go back.
Ms. Hutchinson, you soon, I'm sorry.
I'm definitely gonna go back.
O4 is an ordinance granting a special use permit for Sunbelt Car Wash Services, permitting a car wash in a C-1 general business district.
What's the address to that one?
Yeah.
Says 600 West Service Road.
That's gonna, it'll be on your planning commission.
Okay, it's on for its first reading, give you all an opportunity to go by and look at it, so it'll be back for a second reading in 2 weeks. O5?
O5 is an ordinance waiving competitive bidding to replace the aged and damaged equipment at the West Memphis Flood Control Pump Station, declaring an emergency and for other purposes.
This ordinance was brought up during public works, and I think all the council people unanimously agreed to add to the agenda and bring it forward.
Mayor, may I ask that we spin the rules and place it on second reading?
Second.
Second.
All in favor by aye?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, so second reading.
An ordinance waiving competitive bidding to replace the aged and damaged equipment at the West Memphis Flood Control Pump Station, declaring an emergency and for other purposes.
Mayor, may I ask that we further spin the rules and place it on its third reading?
Second.
All in favor by aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It's on its third reading.
An ordinance waiving competitive bidding to replace the aged and damaged equipment at the West Memphis Flood Control Pump Station, declaring an emergency and for other purposes.
Can I get a motion and second to approve?
Don't move.
Second.
In discussion.
Mayor, I guess one thing, I don't know if Todd's still here. Even though you waive competitive bidding, you still receive quotes, multiple quotes, is my understanding, and this is the lowest of the ones you did receive?
That is absolutely correct. We had an engineer do a formal design, because this motor control center that we're asking for is actually medium voltage, it's actually 4,160 volts these motors run at, not 480. So he did a special, and he went to each company, he went to the three major companies, ABB, Siemens, and GE, and he got quotes. One of them was a verbal quote, the other two were formal quotes given to him, and we are accepting the low bid.
Thank you.
All right, any other discussion? Hearing none, all in favor by aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. Mr. Clerk, would you give that a number as well?
2578.
And we've got the section 2, emergency call.
Yes. 2578. Can I get a motion and second to approve the emergency call?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor by aye?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, that's all of our resolution and ordinances. I'm going to ask for a motion in a second to go into a quick executive session.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, we're going to go ahead and get started back. Can I get a motion in a second to readjourn back into the meeting?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, before we start, I just want to give an explanation of why we went into executive session. I took the council into executive session and answered any questions concerning and giving them the total outcome of the police investigation that we have had going on here in the city. So they are informed that those decisions and what's the next move that we are going to go with here in West Memphis. And I answered any questions or concerns that they may have had. That's the reason why we went into executive session, because we're dealing with employees here, so personal and private information. All right. Permission request for the mayor to sign an agreement between the city of West Memphis and Tower Ventures. I asked in pre-council that we would table that for 2 weeks. Can I get a motion in a second?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It's tabled. To next week.
Well, 2 weeks. Yes.
2 weeks. I'm sorry. I don't know why I keep saying next week. Yeah. Also, permission for a certificate of public convenience for a taxi cab service. Can I get a motion in a second to approve?
Make a motion.
Second.
All right. Any discussion?
Mayor, I guess just so I understand, currently we only have one service in West Memphis, correct?
From my understanding, I think Razorback closed down, so I don't think we have none, unless it's something that I haven't
seen any cars in a while.
Mm-mm. I know we have specialty services. I think we have two of those. But
yeah.
Okay.
Were there any other questions about this?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
All right, can I get a motion and second to approve the planning commission recommendations?
What's the name of this service?
What's the name of your service, your taxi?
Triple C.
Triple C.
Triple C.
Thank you all.
All right, can I get a motion and second to approve the Planning Commission recommendations?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Uh-huh.
Opposed? All right, it passes. Also, this the second item that was added. It's the Chestnut Liens that I was asking to see what you all find in your heart to release these liens off the property so the house can go to being built.
May I say something before then?
Yes, sir.
I went over there and looked after they had started, and they had cleaned that place up, so it looked like a totally different spot. They went in there and knocked those trees down, all that brush, and and they had so many tires for there, you can't imagine. They had just dumped back in there. And they have done so much in there till I'm for releasing the lien, because they didn't clean that thing up. And if they do no more than just do that, I would release the lien for that, because they have cleaned up over there. And I wish y'all would vote with me on that, because I see that going forward. Thank you.
I have a question. Are we looking into the direction of possibly building more homes over there and doing away with the trailers?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Affordable homes. Okay. They're going to be affordable homes and get them trailers out of there.
That's what we're doing. Actually, Dr. Bruce, once this meeting over, I'd like to talk to you and tell you the plan. I hate to put it out.
All right.
You know that.
Okay.
All right, there any other discussion? I get a second to Councilman Mundy's motion.
Some.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. And I guess we'll get that information that is waiting. All right. Public Works, you said you have the minutes, Councilman?
No, we met this past Tuesday on schedule. We just got the follow-up notes yet.
Okay.
But I would like to make a comment about May the 15th is the America Beautification Day.
Okay.
And there's going to be dumpsters set at each ward. That May the 15th is a Saturday, so I was wanting to say this until Ms. Councilor Muhammad was here, because she's doing the administrative side of it, and I was doing the other side of it. So, but the I'll get with Nick and John Rick and give them some of the details so they could start publishing it.
Is it safe to say you missed Councilwoman Muhammad on that Public Works project?
Well, let me tell you something. She's a diamond. I mean, she's done it so much, she could do it by looking at the back of her hand. And for someone just to walk into it like I did, it was a little bit difficult to pick up everything that had to be done. But the dumpsters are ordered. They'll be set in place on the 13th, which is actually a Thursday. And then Saturday the 15th will be the cleanup day, and they're going to leave the dumpsters out till the 19th for people to continue to use them. And hopefully we get a lot of stuff cleaned up. I've already got some people over in Ward 3 and Ward 1 that are asking about some of the sign-up sheets and some of the shirts that you get, and they want to do some cleanup. We had an organization here was one of them, and they're going to be a good part of what we do, I think. So, but anyhow, I can tell you the locations. In Ward 1, it's going to be Matthews Park. Ward 2 is going to be behind the Civic Center, Eugene Wood Civic Center. Ward 3 is going to be West Memphis Christian. Ward 4 is going to be Bettis and Thompson. And Ward 5 is going to be 17th and Jackson.
Give me 4 again.
4 is going to be Bettis and Thompson.
Betty and Thompson.
Mm-hmm.
And 5?
5 is going to be 17th and Jackson. Ward 1 is Matthews Park.
Yes, yeah, that's it.
And 2 is Civic Center.
2 is the Civic Center.
Okay. 3 West
Memphis. Yeah, West Memphis Christian.
Okay.
That concludes your report.
Well, that concludes part of it. I'll do the rest of it in 2 weeks.
I did want to add, Public Works did, the director reported that they picked up over 600 tires.
They did.
Now, I don't know the tires have seeds in them, but it seemed like when we picked up those 600 tires, they started growing more tires. That's why I've been working with city attorney and the city clerk, who gave me some information about some things the municipal league had recommended. So I have it with city attorney right now, and once he go through and take what out he need to or add, we can make some teeth more stronger in that ordinance, because like I said, when them tires came up, unless the gas seeds leaking, they coming right back in the same spot. So, you know, and another thing too, in order for us to get this city clean, our sanitation department is doing everything they can do. Our citizens really got to help us. Simply, if it's just cleaning your own property, cutting the yard, picking up everything in your yard, that will help go a long way in making our city better. We can't do it all alone. Me and Councilman Bruce talked a little bit about it, and he was very adamant, like with the trash. Put your trash in a trash bag. Just don't throw it in the garbage can. You know, make sure you do the things right so we can continue doing what we need to do. Move your trash can up to the front. I got a call, and I had Bonner to go out and talk to the lady, but he showed the Rubicon. Rubicon being one of the best things we ever got. It showed for the last couple of weeks, every time you go back there, your trash is in the back. You're not doing backyard service unless you are disabled and you meet those qualifications. But it don't take nothing to push that garbage to the front and get it empty. So I'm asking as well, I'm asking my department to do more and over beyond what they're supposed to. The citizens got to help us, especially in certain parts of our city.
Well, I've been helping them. They ain't been picking up my garbage on time. I have to go down there every week and tell them to pick up my garbage. And I told them next time I come, I'm just going to come down and dump the garbage down and let them borrow the truck.
Yeah. Well, just call me. Call me. Yeah, I get you. You know, I worked on the back of the garbage truck at one time, so just call me. I'll make sure we get it.
I know that's bad. They're going to take that garbage feed off my light bill.
Yeah, yeah, I guess you're talking to Todd now.
Did police meet?
No, sir.
No,
not yet.
Not yet. Okay. A&P?
Yes, sir. Okay. A&P did meet. I did pass out the notes. I'm not going to read everything verbatim, but I do want to highlight the commissioners agreed to, well, I'm sorry, let me go back. The West Memphis A&P Commission met on March 20th at noon. The commissioners agreed to capacity limitations for the Eugene Woods Civic Center. And I'm making this comment for the public. So 150 will be the number, I'm sorry, Eugene Woods Civic Center of 150, the Civic Auditorium of 250 for the next 90 days. We will revisit the capacity limits according to the number of active COVID cases after 90 days. We also want to make aware of the 10th annual Great State Cook-Off, which will be held this Saturday, May 8th. I don't know if Mr. Jackson wanted to, are you going to let him come up, or is anything that you want to mention, Mr. Jackson, about that Great State Cook-Off on May 8th? This Saturday, right? Yes, sir.
Starting at noon. A&P sponsoring it. $1,500 for the best steak. Paying the first through 10th place steak. Also have an ancillary contest for anything potato. So if you think you can put something in the potato, you've got a chance to win $250 for that. And
Jim,
yes, sir.
Would you please come to the mic? Kind of drop your mask.
Yes, sir.
I want the people to hear because we want them to come out.
Okay, yes. Saturday the 8th from 12 to 6, we're having the state cook-off, 10th annual. And we have music starting at noon. We have Albert King Jr. at noon, Cicely Wellborn in chemistry at 2, and Reba Russell at 4. The cooks that enter, I think it's $150. That includes two prime ribeye steaks cut an inch and an eighth. Very proud to say that Big Star, Gene Stimson's Big Star, is sponsoring and providing those steaks at cost, which, by the way, steaks, even at cost, are still pretty expensive. But they're cooking for a $1,500 first prize, and we pay out first through 10th. Also have a anything potato contest. They can anything that's cooked on the grill on site has a chance to win $250. We'll have the Main Street program is sponsoring a cornhole bag toss tournament. We'll also have a People's Choice. So for $5, you can come down and. Probably we'll have 25 entries in that. So for $5, you can have 25 bites of steak, which is that should take care of you. And those guys will be that's winner take all on that. So if we have 25 entries, it's $25 to enter. That includes one steak, and so they could walk away with $625 for that. So have
Jim, did you
drinks, cold drinks, and food there, and good music and. Steaks cooking should smell good at least.
I may have missed it, but how many entries do you have?
As of Monday morning, we had 37.
37.
And we're going to cap it at 50.
Okay.
And I think we're going to have a good crowd. I think people have cabin fever, all the stuff going on. And I want a good crowd. We are asking people to please be observant of the restrictions, which, or at least be considerate. So I'm hoping we'll have a good crowd. I'd like to have the problem of having too many, I think people are going to have, I think if the weather cooperates and looks like it is, I think we're going to have a good turnout. We might even get the mayor out there to say a few words and give a trophy away or something.
No, I'm going to taste the steak.
Yeah, I know that. I know that. How many bites you get last year, 2 years ago?
No.
You don't want to talk about it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. I hope everybody comes out.
free event, 12 to 6 on Saturday.
Thank you, Jeb.
Thank you so much.
Councilwoman Hutchinson, did that finish your report?
Yeah, that concludes the AMP. Like I said, everybody has a handout.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Did FAR meet?
We met, but we didn't have a quorum. Okay. So we just sit and discuss. They don't have anything really going on right now. So.
Okay. Utility?
Utility has not met, but two separate sessions. We met today at 11 o'clock to go over some of the stuff that we talked about today.
Okay.
And then Todd joined the Public Works Commission meeting the other day and talked about some other stuff. So I'm utilityed out.
Okay. Also, Mr. Peterson, while you're here, could you give an update on the letters, that the utility letters? That the people would get, yeah.
All right. As y'all know, we had a major freezing event during the month of February. For 2 weeks, we had below freezing weather in Arkansas. As y'all know, it also affected portions of Texas. During that time, the electrical system had some issues where the amount of energy flowing on it got reduced greatly. Just for instance, our coal facilities, the coal piles actually froze at one of our facilities and was not able to produce power, okay? During that time, the cost of electricity for about a week got high. Not high compared to Texas high in the ERCOT region, but it still got high. Some of the things that help us offset that is we have some fixed price contracts that helped us keep the pricing lower. But our normal cost of electricity, we saw a increase in the cost where I would have had to collect, on top of what we normally collect in the month of February, an extra $750,000. When I went to put that into the fuel adjustment, because that was an extra cost, the customers, which their normal rate is 6 cents per kilowatt hour, it was going to add in just fuel adjustment 3 cents on top of the really high usage rates that they already had. My commission made a decision that instead of collecting that all in 1 month like we normally do, to only collect a small portion. What we normally do, it was actually a three-year average. It was the previous three-year average was with $60,000, okay, dollars, okay? So we collected $60,000 in fuel adjustment. It lowered the fuel adjustment cost way down, and the cost per kilowatt hour was still low, okay? This past month, I collected $350,000 of that $750,000, okay? But because the customer's actual usage was way down, their total bill was not as high. So most of our customers don't look at it and go, well, what's my cost per kilowatt hour? They look at the bottom line and say, is my bill $100 or is it $150? So even though the fuel adjustment was a higher number, the cost per kilowatt hour was higher, okay, their total bill was lower. So by doing that, we helped the customers. I still have $300,000 I still have to collect. It was $758,000. The first month we only collected 60. This past month I collected 340. And then this month I'm going to collect the rest. And then we'll be back to our normal, what y'all have seen in the past. Again, the commission allowing us to do what they did, it helped spread that extreme cost we had over several periods. And I can tell you guys, with our rate structures and the way we've been set up where, you know, what Mayor Johnson instilled in me is, hey, it's better to have a bird in the bush than go looking for two. having some fixed price contracts has saved us, because I can tell you, I know of communities in that 2 week period saw fuel adjustment cost of $15 million that they had to collect from their customers in Arkansas. So I think we rode through that very well. And it wasn't the contracts, it wasn't our fixed price contracts that cost us. It was our coal plants, where they're normally supplying the energy, they went down. And then the cost of that electricity coming from the market. Is that good?
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Todd.
Airport?
They haven't met yet.
Parks? Yeah. Councilman Mundy?
Are we through with all that? We through with them?
Yeah, I mean, do we have any other?
Now, the airport, I was waiting for the airport to say something.
They haven't met.
We haven't met, that's Charles.
Oh, okay. Have all committees met?
We're in the first week, so.
Now, are we going to make our new commissioner?
Yeah, we're going to go to appointments next.
Okay. Okay.
Well, we have an appointment, so, Councilman Mundy?
I'd like to make a request that we vote for Al Felton as our new commissioner.
Second.
In discussion?
I guess just clarification, utility commissioner.
Utility commissioner, I'm sorry.
Okay. All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Opposed? It passes. Mr. Al Felton is now on the utility commission. He has to be sworn in first, and then he'll take
a... When you have your next meeting?
Next Thursday at
8:30. Okay. I just want to say something here real quick. Ms. Hicks brought something to my attention this morning, you know, to the clerk's office, which was, I'm glad she did. Well, in the ordinance, it states that when you travel, you have to come back with an agenda. And like she say, most classes, they're not in an actual agenda. So what I want the senior clerk to get with the city attorney and see what we can work up. I'm just saying, because when they came back this time, the paperwork that we got, they didn't actually have an agenda. And so we don't want to just stop paying anyone, because the ordinance said agenda. So, and that's what I wanted to just bring out, so we can get together on that and kind of, because the auditor, one time, they did write us up for it, not the meals. So that's what we're trying to stay on track with, the meals. So we're trying to see what we can come up with that will be, suffice for them.
Okay. All right. I had no presentation, just some recognition. This week is Teachers Appreciation Week. So we thank all our great teachers here at all our schools who are doing a wonderful job. Matter of fact, then we got a couple of teachers on the panel. Yeah. Well, education, yeah. Dr. Bruce, Councilman Murray. As well as Ms. Councilwoman Muhammad is not here, but congratulations. I spoke earlier at their convention today at our ECC right across the street. It's Correctional Officers Week, so I appreciate them as well. I know my sister's going to kill me if I don't say this. Happy National Nurses Week to all of the fine women and men that take care of us. We got some even in our fire department and the paramedics department that take care of us when we're sick or anything. I definitely appreciate them. And this month is National Mental Month. Yeah. Mental health.
Mental health awareness.
Mental health. We got one councilman. It's a choice.
Please, all you can throw my way.
Yeah. And we missed the last council meeting, but it was National Dispatches Week, so we definitely appreciate the women that are truly the first contact to service when we have an emergency here in our city. So I said thank them as well. All right. Only announcement I have is today at 2:30, we have the grand opening for the Fire Station 2 on College Boulevard. So hopefully after this meeting, you all will follow me down there to the grand opening. We had three people that signed up for citizen requests. Ms. Kendra Phillips, I talked with her and got the issue resolve, and I will speak with you, Councilwoman Hutchinson, on what that was about.
Thank you.
But we got that taken care of. First, we have Ms. Tawana Murphy. Will you come forward, please? Yeah. Let me ask you something. You and Mr. Blur going to speak together? You want to just do it together? So, yeah. Come on down, Mr. Blair. I'm going to ask you all to just give your name and your address, and we normally allow 5 minutes, and yeah, I know both of you are working together on the project, so.
Well, good evening. Good afternoon. I am Tawana Murphy, 3321 Burgess Drive in Memphis, Tennessee. I am the owner and CEO of Project Let's Read. Project Let's Read is a summer program, 8 weeks, and that program is to educate our kids on basic English, basic math, and penmanship. In 2019, 68% of our kids could not read by the second grade. 69% of our kids could not read by the time they got to high school. In fact, they were reading on a fifth grade level. Today, they are 3-4 grades behind. The summer program is going to start them on basic reading, basic math, and basic penmanship. The other day I got an email from a parent here in West Memphis. She has a fourth grader that's suffering from depression because he can't read. He can barely read on the first grade level. And they held him back kindergarten, and now he's in the fourth grade, and they're going to hold him back again because he can't read. And so this program is catered to children that cannot read, having a hard time reading, and due to pandemic, they didn't go to school for a whole year. So now we have to double up on their education. And a few years back, I know y'all heard of this thing that they had, this program they had called No Child Left Behind. Well, they left all our kids behind because at this point, they can't read. Somehow, we dropped the ball. We dropped the ball as far as the parents is concerned, and we dropped the ball as far as the teachers is concerned. So we're blaming each other, but both of us, we all are to blame for the education of our kids. And so what I did was, if y'all don't mind, if I can use this quick analogy of how to make a sandwich. And of course, we know that the sandwich, the foundation of the sandwich is a plate. That's the foundation. But when you make a sandwich, you have the top part of the sandwich, which is the mother. The bottom part of that sandwich is the teacher. But of course, you got to have some taste to that sandwich. So you're going to smooth it over with some mayonnaise on both. Then after that, you want to put some meat on there, which is the child. I like turkey. So the child is the meat. Now we have cheese, lettuce, tomatoes, and onions. That represents the knowledge of our kids. So now you have this sandwich, but we have it stacked up. So we got to put the mother on top of it. And when you do that, 9 times out of 10, when we eat a sandwich, what are we going to do? We're going to push it down. We're going to push it down before we can eat the sandwich. So we're pushing it down, and this kid is gaining this knowledge. But when we get ready to bite the sandwich, all of the knowledge fell. That's where we fell our kids at. All of that, the lettuce, tomato, the cheese, the onions, that's all on the floor now. But guess what? We still got a chance to save this child because the mother and the teacher is still holding this meat together so we can actually save this child that's still holding on. Only thing we got to do is pick up what we dropped. Throw that in the garbage. Wash our hands, sanitize it, because y'all know we got COVID, right? And then give them a fresh new cheese, some fresh cheese, some fresh lettuce, some fresh tomatoes, and sprinkle some fresh onions on there. And then we're going to try this again. This time, we're going to push it down where it's going to stick. And now they're learning. So when you bite that sandwich, everything in that sandwich you can taste, which means now you have savored the knowledge that is taught to you. And so what I am bringing to the table, we don't ask them for no money. We're asking for your support. So I need you as City Council to support us, and I need you, Mayor McClendon, to support Project Let's Read. That program starts next month, June 1st. And I'm going to stop talking and let Mr. Blair talk.
We appreciate you all again for giving us this opportunity. As you all know, I work for the school district, Academies of West Memphis. And basically what we're doing is we're asking for you all for your support. And what I mean by support, what we're doing is we just want to move the needle. We don't have a magic wand. After this program's over with this summer, the child won't be reading on the grade level that he or she should. We are realists, but they will be improved. And that's what we want, improvement. And because this is not a one-stop shop, this is something we're going to do continuously throughout the summer. And even I'm going to make it my business to get parents involved, because we have parents, young parents who who are, and it's challenging to be able to fill out applications to even go into jobs. I mean, I know some who even at Family Dollar Distribution Center, they come up there and they walk out the door because they cannot properly fill out applications. We have the resources here in the city for our citizens, but some of them don't know how to take advantage of. And even with Project Let's Read, that's just something I'm going to take upon myself to make sure I can interact and establish a relationship with our parents that need to be able to do certain things to help themselves. But again, we're here to move the needle. I'm a realist. We can't wave this magic wand and say we're going to fix it. We need the teachers. We need you guys. We need parents. And so this is why we want to, present ourselves in this manner. And if you all know of any have any connections to, we're not asking for money for to donate pens, any donations, pens, pencils, things of that nature. We have a list of things that you all even know that's needed. Just bring them up to the library. We're going to be in the Murphy Center. Real nice facility. Love that. Love our new library. And we're going to be out working in the Murphy Center Mondays through Thursdays. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. There was officers' requests. If no one don't have anything, we got the Bridges Library. At the fire station at 2:30. Were there any other announcements for any other council people? Hearing none, can I get a motion and second to adjourn?
So moved.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Thank you.